Hi everyone and welcome back. Welcome to my another video on the nestjs advanced course, and here we are talking about nestjs with the typeORM. TypeORM migrations, the typeORM latest version to 3.x, and how to just do the transactions, how to use the typeORM 3.x APIs with the nestjs. So we are already have worked on this. This is the example which we were working on in our previous videos. Now what I will do is I will just try to show you by running this application. It's already not running, so npm run start dev. Okay, and then we will try to just do some changes so that we can get this application running. Address is already in use, that means this application is already running. Here we can see this is running on port 3010. Okay, and this is your database URL which is being used by database module. So we can just go here and try to see this. Okay, these are our APIs. I mean, this is just like a basic restaurant management API where you can just create your restaurant, add the dishes to the restaurant. I copied this example from my full stack application, and here I can just try to get all the restaurant which is coming empty, right? Because there is no restaurant exist. Now we are trying to add on this typeORM 3.x APIs on the methods here to showcase how to work with typeORM 3.x. So this is our simple application. Here I did some changes which I wanted to apply to the database. So if you want to just do, you can just run the migration. I mean, you can generate the migration. CD apps, and we are on the fourth project, npm run. And the command is migration generate, and you just put the name. Name, and the name is let's say src migrations, and I will just put food order version 3.4. V5. So what it is doing is it is just trying to see if there is any change. There is no change found. Let's see, we have a database package, and here what is our synchronized property? Synchronized is false, that is fine. So now if I do some changes in the database, let's say this is source, and inside I add something inside the entity, let's say, so address we already have, website URL, you can say title, and here I'm just trying to generate this migration. We are not able to do it because I think it is applying the changes directly by the sync property. So whenever I'm changing the entities, it is applying those changes. You can see alter column restaurant, add title. So what happens is I started this application and then I changed this database module synchronize flag. So that is not reflected here. But what happens is what is happening right now is this project is using this typeORM module, and there it is taking synchronize true. So whenever I'm doing the entity change, all those changes are getting reflected here. To disable this, you can just do one thing is you just build this project first. So what you can do is for building the project and fetching the latest version of the project, you can use Knex console. Okay, Knex console, the client is not running. Do we have nestjs-json profile here? Yes, we do have. I don't know what's the problem here. But what we can do is we can build this with the latest version, because we did changes in the database. So we need to build the database first, run in the integrated terminal, or we can just publish a new version. Why I'm saying is, let's say I'm just saying this version is 1.0.1, and then npm run build. Okay, I need to build it from this Knex command only because I'm using some root level package definition. So what I will do is I will close this terminal, close the VS Code and reopen it. And after starting, I can see this. So I can just build this one. So it is just building this package, and I'm trying to get the latest version of this database package. And then you can build your application, which is 04. I lost the track of the names of these applications. I will go to the package JSON and try to know which project it is. Nestjs TypeORM APIs. Okay, let's go there. Nestjs TypeORM APIs. This one, and I will build this again so that it can have the latest changes in the done in the database package added here, because you can see NX console is waiting for the dependent module. So this is all NX. First it will build the database package, and then it will include the database package inside it. And how we can make sure the changes has been imported: go to node modules, dev, database, build, inside dbmodule.js. I can see synchronize false. That means it won't be running my application. It won't be restarting my application whenever there is a database change. So let's go to cd app. I mean, I can start this application from the NX console also. npm run start dev. And then I will do is I will start doing some changes. So this is started now. This is not the application I wanted to start, because that was the restaurant application. So it's in 04 project. npm run start dev. Okay, because names are kind of similar. We'll rename it to 03. I will rename it to 04, so we can avoid some confusion. 04, and I will go to NX console. 0304, and I will build it. And then I will start dev it. I will do start dev so it can start running. Start dev project. We can also check 04 node modules, dev, database, to just cross check that everything is good. So this should be using synchronize false. That's good. And now if I change anything in the database, is it reflecting those changes back? Because we don't want to apply those changes right away. We want to do it through the migration. Let's say I'm just changing this to this column. Okay, that's fine. It is not applying the changes in the database. So let's say I'm just changing it to description. Or let's introduce a new column instead of updating this. So there is a restaurant type, default null. So what I will do is I can just play around with these APIs, TypeORM migrations. So I can just do npm run migration. I can just copy and paste that command. So this is migration generate, and give it some name. npm run migration generate, and give a particular name to this migration. v5, let's say. So it will create this v5 migration, which I will move it to the migrations folder. And you can see v5 contains only that you added just a type, and then I will just do npm run migration run. That will run the migration against the database. So using this, you are not using the synchronized true. You are actually running the migrations and then applying those migration changes against the database. So that is the right way. I mean, for production, this is how you should do it. On the development, you can just change this on the fly by doing the synchronized true property. So whenever you change the entities, it will automatically impact your database. Okay, so now I can start playing with these APIs. Let's say I want to fetch the restaurant. It is making these queries. So I think here is my application running. Right here I'm trying to fetch all the restaurants. So now what is the next thing is we can start using some of the features. Let's say I wanted to create a restaurant. how it is working. I will just give it a try if it works. Okay, it is working. So we are able to create a restaurant, and then I can just try to fetch it and I'm able to get it, right? So how all these things are working, we can also use TypeORM transactions just to play around, and you create the restaurant with the transactions. So let's see here how we are creating a restaurant, right? So you will hit the controller, restaurant controller, and here we do have post API create restaurant, right? It is taking some payload object and then it is doing create restaurant, right? So how, what I'm trying to do here is I'm just trying to play around with the transactions, the old way of doing it, and then we will just use the new way of doing it. So create a restaurant, and here if you see my constructor, I will just try to hide other methods which are coming in our way. Yes, so here we are using this connection. So there are two different ways. Connection is right now deprecated. Connection is a single database, ORM specific to database. And this declaration was marked deprecated. But how we were doing earlier, this.connection.create query runner. So it is giving us the query runner. And then you can just do connect, start transaction, commit transaction once the operation is done. So I'm doing a simple two different writes. Write to the restaurant table and write to the restaurant address table. Right, because I'm getting the payload address object also, restaurant address, so which I'm inserting inside a restaurant address table. This dot create address. So if any of these are failing, then obviously we can just roll back the transaction. Instead of commit, it will be rollback. If everything is done, it will commit all the right operations. Okay, so here it is starting. What I will do is I will try to create the restaurant. And here I did insert Swiggy app. So what it is doing, if you try to see from the query, we can understand start transaction, it did the insert, it did the insert on the restaurant address and the restaurant table, and then it did the commit transaction. That's it, right? So same thing now with the TypeORM, because this is deprecated. What else we can use? We can also use private read only, maybe data source we are getting, and here instead of connection, I can just to use this dot data source dot create query builder that exists on data source also, and I think everything else can stay same. We don't need to change anything, and I will just try to play around with this if it works. So here I will just say Swiggy app version 2202. It is able to create the data. That means it works, right? So this is just another way of creating the transactions. So here, instead of connection, we are just using this dot data source dot create query builder. So all those things, whatever we were doing with this dot connection, you can do same with the this dot data source, right? This dot data source dot query runner, and on the query runner, you can do query connect, start transaction, commit transactions under, or rollback, or finally release, right? And you can pass this query runner to any methods, because query runner will give you a manager object, entity manager object, on which you can do a dot save, dot find, all these different operations. Because if you are passing the same query runner, because that means all the read write you are doing from different methods can be rolled back until unless you don't do a commit. I mean, if there is any error occurred, all these will be rolled back. So if you are passing the same query runner, that means all those read write happens in one transaction. This is the way to deal with the TypeORM transactions using nestjs. I mean, nestjs is a framework only here, but this is how we are doing TypeORM transactions, which is there in 3.x.